Welcome, guys, on my own personal house tour here in my vacation home in Texas, America. Dave Schulman. All right, so we're here. Josh is having Starburst for breakfast. Give him a look, Josh.
Actually, I've just finished my Starburst. But it was the Starburst.
We like to eat like champions when we're drifting. This is our home.
Our Airbnb so far have been kind of boring. That's why I haven't really shown them too much. But this one is interesting.
So obviously the weather here is very different than Ireland. It's very rainy and very cold. You know, your body has to adapt from the tropics of back home, and this is tough on us all. What are you having?
We couldn't be in a more stereotypical American family vacation house now.
Party house. So we've got a bar. We've got lots of wooden furniture in a wooden house on wooden stilts with wooden rooms and wooden beds. Everything's wood. We don't want any.
I think we need to just show the weirdness of the bedrooms.
The weirdness of my organization here too. So
we won't pass any judgment here.
So I've got, like, this is a shelf for me, right? So this is a shelf.
There's your shelf.
Life hack. People say, I've been 32 days away from home. How am I surviving for socks and boxers? I'm technically just throwing them away and buying more socks and boxers, which seems to be getting me this far. I was sleeping here because it's wider, but I'm thinking I might just elevate as the days go on. I think this room is mad. It's not the maddest we have.
You think it's pretty random so far at the house.
It gets better on the second floor.
Yeah, this is where it gets real bizarre.
Yeah, but I don't know if anybody has watched the show Squid Game. Hey.
Yeah, we've got a bit of a party room.
A little bit of football going on. Oh, gee! Ping pong table.
See some bad days.
This is pretty strange.
This is a bit strange.
Like, what is this? Hello!
I've never seen a room like this before.
All right, so it's early in the morning, as you can see by how dark it is, and we're going drifting today, apparently very fast drifting. So it's time to go drifting. We gotta do some stuff first, but let's go do that now.
So whilst we're here, we picked up a few parts for the Verosa. So we got calipers from an IS-300 because they don't sell calipers for an IS-300 in Ireland very easily. So it's easily picked up from the States from a O'Reilly's, and yeah, we're gonna bring them home in our suitcase. That means when we get back to Ireland, we can put them straight on the car and then have brakes, which is always a good thing.
Alright, so we got 3 days left of drift week, and I'm a little worried about this one because this track is super fast, and as much as fast as fun, it's not as fun when you're in a car without huge horsepower because you're kind of going where the car is going, not where you really want to go. So we're going to put some air in the tires. I'm going to do one or two siding laps because I don't really want to go tandem straight away, and then hopefully we like Hallett, we'll get ourselves comfortable towards the end of the day. I think this is another one of those tracks where you're going to see me very tentative at the start and then pushing at the end, and you kind of feel like you've completed the track. So a little bit worried, the car's getting close to the end of drift week now, I don't want to wreck it, and there's a lot of places here where you can go off and actually ride off a car because of wet grass and tire bales and walls, so a little nervous, but we'll just settle into the first few laps and get it going.
Not to make you feel more nervous, but Jimmy said he is drifting four.
Yeah, we'll see when we get out there.
Third was fast.
You know, I'm going in this time with a little bit less gung-ho approach. I'm going to go in and build myself up through the day. That's what I'm going to do.
Thank you.
Alright guys, just want to take a break in this video to talk to you about the new Strom DS05. So, remember a couple of months ago, we told you we were designing a wheel with Strom in collaboration. Well, they're about to arrive, and the first shipment lands at the end of November. They're kind of a really cool wheel. We wanted to take some classic cues from old school wheels with a little bit of a modern twist with the step lip. I think they look absolutely amazing. The minute we get back from this US trip, the first thing we're going to be doing is testing those wheels on some of our cars. I can't wait to see how they came out. But if you want to be amongst the first people to get them on your car and the first batch that arrives, get onto the Strom Wheels website. You got to register your interest. I think that's what you do. Register your interest, and then when they arrive, they'll give you a little email, and then you can buy them straight away. They will be limited stock, and then you don't want to be left wanting them, but you can't buy them. So check out the Strom Wheels website. Check out the DS05s. They look amazing, and I'm excited to actually get home and fit them on some of my cars. I can't wait. All right, let's get back to the action. All right, heading out to track right now. This is how I feel. What do you think? Will we survive? It's not building confidence for me. It's not building confidence. Not too sketchy. There's a lot of runoff on it. There's a lovely section where it's all second gear and it's all just turn. So that's nice for tandem. But I think this track's all about speed. Like, you could probably get up to like 110, 115 mile an hour on entry at some points, which is madness. Like, so we could try some high speed stuff today.
So you thought, what was the other track called? Hallett?
Hallett.
Hallett.
It's a lot faster.
That, you said that was the fastest you're like, ever gone drifting.
As fast as you want here. Like, you could go the run, you could do the straight for up to fifth gear if you wanted, and initiate the handbrake if you wanted. There's no stopping you, like, it's just really long straights. So it just depends how brave you want to be going in. So try and get a little braver as we go. What do you think, Josh? Try and break my high, what's my highest ever drift speed? I think I did 100 and...
You went... Well, at the last track you're entering at 90. So I think you have to break 100.
I think I've done 100 miles an hour before in Mandela under the bridge. I think that was the fastest I've ever gone in there.
Okay, 110 then.
So anything over 100 would be the fastest. 101. But 100, over 100 would be the fastest I've ever drifted. So if we could get like a camera on the speedo, or
I was gonna say, we break out the speedo cam again.
Yeah, maybe.
That sounds really wrong.
I'd say probably leave someone out of the car just to give it every bit of help it could get.
I wasn't this offering.
This was my problem on the last lap. I could feel this happening. So.
Yeah, we're looking at our wear now.
Wayne Curran's alignment.
A measurement and an iPhone.
Airbnb phone alignment tool works.
You want to get your tires and everything straightened up. You want to get some good camber, good drift setup. Find Wayne in the garage somewhere in the middle of Texas, and he'll align it with his iPhone and a measuring tape.
Bring your iPhone and he'll
bring
use his
your iPhone. He'll use his measuring tape,
yeah,
and he'll look at that.
Together, you can get straight alignment.
It will get a bit better now, but
it's a lot better than it was. I'll put it that way. Actual reenactment of Josh in these high speed runs. Look at that face, that's Josh's face.
That's exactly on my face when you're going over 100 miles an hour.
Put it to just dub this over. It. Like
genuinely terrified.
I'm a little terrified myself, to be honest. Mom, we'll try.
90 miles an hour is fast.
Let's try and break 100 and we'll work our way up.
Work our way up?
What?
Let's start at 90 and work our way up.
100 and work our way up.
We'll be fine.
I'll be recording all the vlogs from here on out. Wayne will be editing them on TikTok because Josh and Dave are going to die.
They're saying you're going to do a great job.
Couldn't have more support for you, Dave.
He's not going to do well.
I would say we've done some pretty sketchy stuff in our time. I would say this is definitely up there as one of the sketchiest.
This could be sketchy though.
Like whatever about doing stuff in a fully like caged comp car and everything. I'm in a standard seat.
We're in jeans. We're jeans drifting faster than we've ever drifted before.
If that doesn't give you confidence, I'm not sure what will. That is a long ass straight. That's almost proof that the Earth's not flat. It's that long, it's actually dipping down. Okay, here we go, I guess. You initiated later then, you actually initiated pretty much on the 300 yards to the corner.
I think she can go later.
I'm not sure I want to see later.
That was like, I can't see exactly where the speedo is, but
I say you guys know how fast that was more than we do, but.
Yeah, I'd say it was definitely 105 plus, maybe more.
I can confirm it was fast as
it's not too bad, like it's controllable. Like when this car-
Try sitting in this seat.
No, but you know you're going super fast when you're spinning the wheels in fourth in this car. Because we could barely spin them in third on the last track and then I'm spinning them in fourth. And down to third.
Ah, oh, crap, Dave.
What?
I hate to break it to you, but the MPG's not too good.
Oh no.
You're 15 miles to the gallon.
That's some extreme right there.
Yep.
What? No, whatever about doing it in your pro drift car when, like, this car has done about 20 hours of road driving, it's wobbly, everything's all kind of, it's a stock car. So, like, whatever about a pro car doing it in a stock car is so much scarier.
Yep. I'm gonna have a cup of tea.
Oh my god. No fucking way. You went
120 miles an hour.
What the
So you were all from the. You handbrakes so, initiated, didn't you?
Obviously, I'm going to end up in the moon if I don't. But it basically, the last drift corner, I'm not drifting it. I'm coming out in second, third on the next one, and then pull fourth, and then just absolutely sending it. And I'm waiting as late as I can,
and then pull the
handbrake. So, like, I'm at the 300 marker, which is fairly close to the corner, and then big angle, and it's spinning the wheels in fourth, which that would never do. Yeah. And then it's just down to third and send it through. It's not as bad, but then you get really bad flat spots for the next
one. It definitely is as bad. I don't know what he's talking about.
Yeah, it's like, well, it's fun though. That's the fastest.
120, I didn't think it was 120 there.
No cage streetcar.
Safety first.
No idea what the runoff is.
It's just grass and water.
It's critters. Yeah. I think we can go faster.
On your own.
Do you know what? I think it might actually be good to take a bit of weight out of the car with you and try and see if she just give it a little bit more on the run-up.
I mean, that could be the difference between a few miles an hour there.
You could be. So, like, if we break 120 mile an hour today, that's all we need to do.
So, there's no avoiding that. I was absolutely cacking my pants in the car with Dave because it was just a street car. And to be fair, it was a little bit silly what we were doing at that high speed in a uncaged car. But on Drift Week, a lot of the cars do have cages, including one of my favorite cars on this trip. So, I'm here with Elliot. This is my favorite car in Drift Week.
Thank you.
This is like fairly stock, isn't it?
Yeah, it's basically stock, just with an FD cage. Rome did it. It's got full FDF arms, angle kit, BC coilovers. Power is stock. I just did the oil pump gear because it's a weak point on this engine. Headers and a flex fuel tune. That's it.
It's like, as far as the drift car goes, like out of the box, this is as stock as they come, really. You just put a few drift parts on and it's good to go.
Yeah, most of the modification actually comes from, and like it not being stock anymore is for like competition safety regulations.
Let's go for a spin. But yeah, I'm most happy about it as a cage because going with Dave was sketchy as f***. Wouldn't say you'd be able to hear me. Pretty f***ing rowdy. We were twinning in a whole new way then. Experience, dude.
Yeah, that was for coming along.
That was rowdy. That was, I know why Vaughn keeps on saying these things are rowdy, because they are. Definitely think you're out of tire.
Yeah, 100%. This thing is f***ing rowdy.
I love it. Well done.
I don't know why I was talking on that, because it couldn't be anyways.
Yeah.
Josh, when you were off gallivanting having a bit of fun, something cool turned up and I wanted something a little bit special. That's why I wanted to grab you out of the car and show you this. I know we see a lot of these, and actually I was chatting to the owner there and he was like, oh, sick, I know you see them so much in Ireland, but it's actually done really differently. Check out this SR20 powered Corolla.
This reminds me of, you know, the old school players livery.
That's exactly what it is, Josh.
Oh,
it's John Player Special. His name is John. His initials is also J. I'm not sure if JSY or JYS. He remade the livery to match.
Yeah.
That's what it's really. That's what's done differently.
You know what? A little bit rough, but I think that's how crawlers have to be. They have to be a little bit rough. This is my favourite bit.
There,
John Yim special.
There you go. John Yim is his name. And he's remade the logo.
Jimmy just smelt what he calls as God's motor. It's like, what's going on here, guys?
This is the smallest set of Meisters I've ever seen in my life. The mini Meisters. There she is.
This
is what we're talking about. I wish I could do this mine, but everyone would have f***ing been so mad with it.
You say they might be the smallest Meisters you've ever seen, because I don't think they're actually Meisters.
Mini Meisters.
I think they might be Schmeisters.
Schmeisters. Oh, they are Schmeisters. It's okay. They're still cool from afar. This car is sick, though.
John Yim special. We approve.
Hopefully his SR is better to him than you.
So, Drift Week. We are now many, many days in. About 3 days to go. And the cars are starting to suffer. So I think Luke Fink's gearbox has let go. which is not good, obviously, in a Corvette, because it's in the back, and who knows that more than anyone than me.
Came over at the right time, right?
What happened?
I don't know, I was literally just driving back in, and I stopped at the flag point, drove off, and it was just f***ing
hurt. That's what James Dean said when his car caught on fire.
And it's first, and like, it'll come into neutral first, but won't let me go across, or in there. Yeah, it's just...
I wasn't doing anything, it's just mad. Just driving.
Would it be a selector?
I'd say selector 4 or something.
Ooh.
This is a little find, isn't it? Just walked in here and saw an LS. That could be an LSX. Datsun 240Z. It's basically the engine from my Corvette. If I put it in my Datsun 240Z, it would look like this. It's a nice build, isn't it? She was obviously in a crash.
She's seen a few bangs,
this thing now. So it's obviously been... Which is good, though, because it's not that, like, they took an original car and cut it up. It's obviously car had damage, and then they made it into... This would be some drift car.
That's very tidy. I like this. You like it, Wayne?
Yeah.
All right, so you know what? We could say we hit 120 miles an hour, but I feel like we just got to the edge of 120 miles an hour. So we're going to change the setup on the car a little bit. I'm getting a lot of wheel spin coming out of the corner before it and kind of trying to keep it straight before I can actually gun it. So we're going to put on 255 Valinos. We're going to drop the tire pressures to about 10 PSI, which means that we're going to get no tire, basically tire spin at all, and see if we can grab another couple of mile an hour on the run-in. If we hit 120 miles an hour, which is like 193 or 5 kilometers an hour today, that would be the fastest I've ever drifted, ever entered in any car, and it would be in a stock car. So we have had some fun tandems all week. We did really good tandems at the last track. I feel like this is the one that we want to break the top speed record. So we're going to have a little bit of lunch, settle at the car cool, and then we're going for it. Quite a bit on that, but I'm proud I didn't. My car is also filling with smoke, as you can see, because we had a rear quarter panel incident which got rid of the second skin, so she gets a little smoky, but yeah, I'm pretty happy with all that. All right, so we are finished today at MSR. Is MSR the name of this one?
MSR.
Look at Adam's lovely little high-vis there. Look.
It's the most degrading high-vis you've ever seen. It's almost like a bra.
He's almost half cameraman, half stripper.
Because these are people who don't bring high vis, she makes them look like morons. You noticed that last year.
Nobody touched his teeth.
Two things I want to do. One was enter faster than I've ever entered before in a drift, which I achieved. And I wanted to do the whole layout without the handbrake, which I also did. So I was like, there's two things I would probably never have done at home. not used the handbrake and gone that fast that I've achieved today. So it feels good to shake off some of your like preconceptions of what you're capable of. I think this week has definitely shown me I can go faster, I can go harder, and I don't need as many safety nets in the car. So I'm really happy with the progress.
Why have you been plowing?
Oh, Jimmy, did you go plowing again?
I was like, what's burning right now? Grassman Jim.
Feed the cows.
Feed the cows.
Well, Adam, how did you get on?
Useless!